number. Thank you. We are still giving room for the prayers. Thank you, Father. So let's continue with the importance of entrepreneurship to an economy. When there is activities of entrepreneurs in the country, what or how does the country benefit? If there are very many managers in each and every part of the country running business, different kinds of business, how does the country benefit? So first, before we go into the importance, let's understand what entrepreneurship is. It contributes to the economic growth and development in the following ways. What are the ways? One, it creates employment. If the country is serving entrepreneurs, business and managers, then they are able to employ other people. They are able to what? Employ other people from different parts of the country. And that employment helps the citizen of that country, helps the citizen of that economy, and their living standard will be improved. You see? So that is one of the benefits. That is one of the benefits that the entrepreneurship contributes to the work. The country, the population of the country will be employed. Understand? A good example, you have Burera. Burera is a private, and it has been started by them. An idea of what? Entrepreneurship. And therefore, you have got different people working in Burera as a private entity. And therefore, those people are able to earn the what? They are able to earn their income, and the population are able to what? Have remain employed. And that is a benefit you can see in the country. And people, the population can also even pay the tax to the country. So that is it. Then the next contributes to the formation of the capital. So when you say the contribution to the formation of the capital, this means that entrepreneurs may contribute to the what? The creation of capital to help in expanding. So if you are a manager and you have been doing a business and you are obtaining profits, let's say that you want to start maybe another business. The entrepreneurship will be a source of contribution of the capital in starting a new business. Let's say that you are dealing in school and maybe you want to open a restaurant. You will get the profit from school and open a restaurant. That means that entrepreneurship as an activity in the country has enabled us to have capital. It has acted as a formation of what? Capital to starting new businesses or expanding other businesses through what is known as plowing back profit. Plowing back what? Plowing back. What is known as plowing back profit? What is plowing back profit? What is plowing back profit? Plowing back profit, this is a profit that has been obtained from the business after the cost has been removed. So that profit that has been obtained from the business can be used to start or expand other businesses apart from the business where the profit has come. So that is what it is. Then the next importance of entrepreneurship in the country, improved its infrastructure. Where businesses take place, where there are very many managers with their companies, they will always need good roads. They will always need good and better communication network. They will always need hospitals and social amenities around. So that improved the what? The infrastructure. In which way? You can look on the screen. It has set up many businesses in a particular area, makes government to see a need to improve. So when government sees that there are very many businesses set up in a certain area, they will see the need to improve the infrastructure in terms of building roads inside areas. And also, entrepreneurs may join a hand in improving what? Entrepreneurs themselves, they can also chip in providing such infrastructure inside areas. For example, road. For example, communication network. Example, building schools, hospitals, recreational centers, and etc. So that is another importance of entrepreneurship activity in the country that is in. The next, reduces foreign dominance in the economy. There are some of the goods that always come mainly from the United States of America, mainly from Germany. So when they come to Kenya, they dominate other local goods in the country. But if they are same what? If they are same local companies that are producing the same goods in the country, anti-entrepreneurship, then they will reduce the dominance from the local what? Goods from the foreign what? Countries. Let's say that you have got shoes that are coming from Turkey dominating the Kenya. You understand? So if there is an entrepreneur coming up with the shoe industry here in country, in our country Kenya, then he will try or she will try to dominate, to reduce the domination from the foreign country that is Turkey. So that is a benefit, because when the country depends on its local products, then the countries obtain a lot of good things in terms of maybe revenue or tax being collected with the government, and even everything that's supported. So local entrepreneurship reduces the number of foreign investors, and then even foreign investors. There is no need for a person to come and establish an industry here which can be established by the same or local person. So that has been dealt with, and that is a benefit to the country. Then the next one makes use of local resources. Because there is entrepreneurship in the country, there are some of the resources that have not been put into use. The entrepreneurship will use those resources, that is resources, and enable them to what? To come up with what? What is needed for a country to grow. So for example, you can look on the screen that the entrepreneurship creates a conducive environment that makes the exploitation of local resources possible. And what are these resources that can entrepreneurship can put in use, or this system can put in use? For example, resources like scrap metal can be what? Scrap metal can be what? Can be used to make what? GMOs, you can see that. That is a kind, one source of, you can say recycling, because there are metals that are being used, the scrap metal, they can be recycled back and be manufactured or be what? Made it something very important or something very substantial as far as our kitchen is concerned. So that is another importance of entrepreneurship activity in the Jokale industry. It is an important. So because those local resources are being used. Then the next, promotes technology. In entrepreneurship in the country, there is promotion of technology. How? Through their creativity. These managers, the CEO, chief executive officer, these people who are having business, most of them are having creative mind. They are coming up with an idea, business idea, that's enabled them to obtain profits. And you see that creativity can be able to be shared among other people. So their creativity, entrepreneurs can contribute to the development of new technology. Understand? They can come, if they use maybe to do something manually or keeping the record manually, they can come up with maybe a software where they do that on the computer. And that's creativity. And that will help in the development of the country. And creativity can come in different forms. For example, you can see on the screen whereby somebody comes up with the development of charcoal. Charcoal refrigerator. That's a creativity. So all of these brings or these give credit to the country or the economy. You see, that's another important. Then the next, promote entrepreneurship culture. That culture of entrepreneurship in the country. Once there is entrepreneurship activity in the country, that culture is being promoted by the entrepreneurship in the country. So successful entrepreneurs act as eye opener to the society. When the country is having many entrepreneurs who have succeeded in life, who are having big business, better business, then they act as eye opener. People look up to them to give them what? A way forward on how to operate a successful what? Business. So these people will be able, always encouraging societies and members to engage in entrepreneurship what? Activities. And that is an important here. Then the next, reduces rural migration. When an entrepreneur establishes a company mainly in Kwale, you'll find that somebody coming from Kwale will not be able to move to Mombasa to look for a job in Mombasa while there is a company in Kwale that is able to employ that kind of person. So because of this, it is able to help this person to reduce rural urban migration. People will not be able to move to the urban to look for a job while the entrepreneur has established companies and the organization in the rural area. You can look on the screen what that means. Entrepreneurs can set up businesses into rural areas where they can employ rural population, thereby preventing them from moving to urban area in search of what? Job. So that is it. Then the next importance, always think of that to give you much as much as points that will be good for you at least to look at the variety and at least to think about, at least to get everything, a variety. That's what I always advocate. So the next, raising standard of living. That's another importance of entrepreneurship activity in the country. It raises standard of living. Why? Because people are getting employed. It always goes hand in hand with that topic, or with the point which was talking about, it creates employment, which was the first point. So it raises what? Standard of living. So entrepreneurship avails a variety of goods. People come up with different goods because they are creating or they are manufacturing. Then, and services to people to enable them to lead a better world life. So this helps these people to have a world, a better livelihood, because there are a variety of goods and services. And besides salaries paid to the workers by the entrepreneur, they enable them to afford high quality of goods and what? Services. So this is just connected to creation of employment. So let's make this one the first the part of this. Let's continue the next one. Thank you.